voice that God gave to me very clearly in May 1982. It's, if you like, my motto or life verse that I asked for. And it's a psalm that emphasizes God's sovereignty over all the earth and invites and encourages God's people to sing in celebration and to declare good news. For me, it became my call to action and motivation for each new day. I trust it will continue long after the 31st of July. As for singing in celebration, when I was appointed to be Bishop of Lancaster, they asked me at York Minster what hymns would I like, and then promptly refused to have them. And one of them that I asked for was In Christ Alone. And they refused because of the line about God's wrath. Now, when the Blackburn clergy heard about this, it meant, in response and reaction, for the first 12 months, everywhere I went, we sang In Christ Alone. And it became a kind of anthem, really, and a sort of symbol to me of the warmth and hospitality and friendship across the diocese.
I don't love change. I'm a settled soul. And when I was a child, even when we went on holiday, when my mum wasn't looking, I put a couple of little ornaments in the suitcase so that when we arrived, I would still feel at home. And I envy those who have roots. But God has a sense of humour. And in my married life, home number 10 is coming up. At least we hope it is. But there's a lovely verse, Psalm 84 and verse 5. Blessed are those whose strength is in you, who have set their hearts on pilgrimage. This Christian life is unsettling in the way God calls us to live it. You will have seen the card parents are sometimes given. And there's a quote accredited to Jonas Salk, which says, good parents give their children roots and wings. Roots to know where home is, wings to fly. And as children of our Heavenly Father, our roots are in Christ. We find our home and our security in Him as we trust His Spirit to help us to fly. And Jeff was first on the move in this diocese with a 100-mile prayer walk. And two more came later, Herrick and Sam Cawley, and me, visiting parishes, sharing their encouragements, listening and offering prayer for their concerns.
When she has found it, she calls together her friends and neighbours, saying, rejoice with me, for I have found the coin that I had lost. Just so, I tell you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Can we trust Him to be the one who provides for our needs? What does it mean to travel light in today's culture? And how open are we to the company of strangers? The answers to those questions are what help to shape our discipleship. It's nothing new. John Bunyan knew of it in the 17th century when he wrote Pilgrim's Progress, which has long been a favourite of Jeff's, and which the confirmation camp team finally, after many years of Jeff asking, agreed to have as its theme last year. It's why we chose our next hymn. But let me leave you with words from John Bailey's devotional classic, A Diary of Private Prayer, the updated version of which Bishop Julian sent to all the clergy of the diocese at Christmas, I think last year. And I read these words, somehow Jeff's copy seems to have found its way into my books, just the other day. My life today will be lived in time, but it will involve eternal issues. Let me keep in mind that the things that matter are not money or possessions, not houses or property, not bodily comforts or pleasures, but truth and honour, gentleness, helpfulness, and a pure love of God in Christ. And so, Father, on my pilgrim journey, he writes, toward eternity, let me not try to deaden or destroy the desire for you that disturbs my heart. Let me rather give myself over to its persuasion and go where it leads me.
You might notice that I'm a bit shorter than the previous speaker. Luke 15, which we've just read, Judith's just read, is a fantastic chapter and includes one of my favourite verses. Jesus welcomes sinners. I don't know about you, but I am so glad that verse is in the Bible. I don't think there's much going for any of us, to be honest, without that word. Jesus welcomes sinners. And it then includes the chapter Deep Insights into How Our Heavenly Father Feels About the Lost. Lost people matter to God. They stir the Father's heart. They matter so much that he sent Jesus. And our evangelism, our good news, is a real opportunity to tell people they matter. They really do matter. Now, recently I've been taken up with the Bishop's Bible Challenge. I've been thrilled that over 3,000 children have completed it. And they had to engage with 8 stories in Luke's Gospel about finding things, finding faith, finding fellowship, finding forgiveness, finding peace. I'm just so thrilled and grateful to all the teachers, head teachers, RE coordinators, all those who've inspired the children and kept them motivated, checked the challenges, given them their stickers when they've completed it. You won't be surprised with the next hymn, which includes the words, Lord, for that word, the word of life which fires us, speaks to our hearts and sets our souls ablaze, teaches and trains, rebukes us and inspires us. Lord of the word, receive your people's praise. Let's do that. Let's praise.
Shire's Head, Winnie Brow Lane, it sounded like something from Lord of the Rings. But far from fantasy, the reality has been faithful, loving, welcoming people where we have been able to belong. It's given us opportunities to serve and taught us townies what rural ministry is and how it works. We have made mistakes over these last 10, 11 years. We have done those things which we ought not to have done. And we have neglected to do things we might have done. But we ask God, just as our vicar used to memorably pray at the end of every service when Jeff was first a curate, we ask God to forgive us for the imperfections of our worship and service. And we give thanks to God and this diocese for giving us the chance to have the best of both worlds, a local as well as a wider ministry. And as we move on, we pray in the words of the end of 2 Peter, that we and you may continue to grow in the grace and knowledge of God, our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. To him be glory, both now and forever. Amen.
Such a joy and a privilege to share in that ministry across the diocese. And in it, worked with lots of different teams, whether it's confirmation, camp, Bible challenges, whatever. And I've known some outstanding colleagues. You need to realise that the team around Bishop Julian, working on Vision 2026 with the parishes, is a very special group of people who really do hold on to the role of the servant against the welter of ecclesiastical machinery, and is seeking, and I believe, more and more modelling quality relationships. Guys, you do need to know what a great team they are, and they do need your love and support and prayers as they seek to do the same for you. I've been surrounded in my ministry by a lot of gifted people. God is so good. Judith, my secretary, has been amazing in her work for the body of Christ. Her gift of administration stretches that gift to new dimensions. As Jean indicated, the men of Shire's Head have kept me grounded, and running partners like Clive and Paul have ministered to me in ways that they will never understand. Chris and I, early on, visited one of our mentors, Bishop Richard Hare. We wanted his blessing and his advice for our new Episcopal roles. Richard echoed the words and ministry of Bishop Edward King, some of you may have heard of, a very famous Lincolnshire bishop, and highlighted gentleness alongside servant ministry. Edward King actually confirmed my grandfather in Lincolnshire and took as his motto text from Psalm 18, the AV version is, "Thy gentleness hath made me great." I don't know whether you know St. Swithin's day-to-day, who was known also for his gentleness. Both bishops taught me that gentleness is not weakness, but it is restrained strength. And they pointed to the gentleness and the strength of Christ. One who says, "Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me." For I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy
at my bed is love.